Hello everyone, we'll solve the sum. They are given cos x cube into sin square x power 5. First of all, here cos x cube and sin square x power 5 both combine with multiplication. So we have to use the product rule first. Inside the product rule, here they are given x power 3. This comes under the chain rule. Even here also sin square is coming and x power 5 also coming. Here also we have to substitute the chain rule. So this particular sum we have to solve, start with product rule and it goes to the chain rule. We'll start now. Now we'll take entire thing as y. Y cos x cube into sin square x power 5. We'll differentiate dy by ds equal to. This first we have to substitute the product rule. You know already product rule, uv is nothing but uv dash plus v u dash. That means whatever coming the first term you have to write as it is, then second term you have to differentiate. Next you add it and you write second term as it is without differentiation and first term you differentiate and write. This used to call the product rule. Otherwise you can write uv equal to u dv by dx plus v into du by dx. Now we'll substitute that product rule. First we'll take this is u and this is v. So entire this thing, entire this one is u and entire thing this is v, will take it. Now u as it is will write cos x cube into, will differentiate sin square x power 5 divided by dx. So first portion we completed plus the second portion. So v, this is v, you write as it is sin square x power 5. And we have to differentiate the term u. U is nothing but here we have taken cos x cube divided by dx. That's it. Now, dy by dx equal to cos x cube. Now we have to differentiate sin square x power 5. But here we have to apply the chain rule. In the chain rule, the first priority goes to the power. So as per this, square takes the first priority. So x power n equal to n into x power n minus 1. So we'll substitute here. This is the power. 2 is the power. It comes front. 2 sin 2 minus 1 and the x power 5. Now we differentiated square. So we applied the chain rule for the square. Now we have to apply the chain rule for the sine. That means differentiation of sine x power 5 by dx. Here, when you are substituting chain rule for the sine, we should not put the square here because square already resolved. We solved the square chain rule. Only sine you have to take and the sine function. Okay, next. Plus, this will take it. Sine square x power 5, we write as it is because we need not to differentiate this. If you differentiate cos, differentiation of cos x you know. Differentiation of cos x is nothing but minus sine x. That will substitute here. So here we get minus sin x cube. We can't stop here itself because x cube also a function, differentiable function. Then we have to substitute the chain rule here. That means differentiation of x cube by dx. Now dy by dx equal to cos x cube into 2 sin 2 minus 1 is 1 x power 5. Now we have to differentiate the sine. For differentiation of sine is nothing but cos. So cos x power 5. Here itself we can't stop it because we don't have x here. Instead we have x power 5. So again we have to differentiate using the chain rule. So now differentiation of x power 5 divided by dx plus. Now we'll come here. Sine square x power 5 into this minus, we can bring it instead of plus. We can put the minus here because plus into minus, minus both combine with the multiplication. Now sin x cube. Now we have to differentiate the x cube. X cube is this formula again, x power n equal to n into x power n minus 1. So 3 comes in the front and x power 3 minus 1. That's it. Now dy by dx equal to cos x cube. R2 will bring it in the front to sin. Anything power 1 need not to write it. Okay, now we'll write simply x power 5 and cos x power 5 into, now we have to differentiate this again. For this x power 5 we should substitute the formula x power n equal to n into x power n minus 1. So 5 comes to the front, x power 5 minus 1 minus, now 3 is there, we will bring the 3 in the front, 3, x power 3 minus 1 is nothing but x square. Here sine x cube and sine square x power 5, that's it. Now dy by dx equal to, now almost differentiation is completed, chain rule also we applied, only thing is we have to rearrange. Usually when you are rearranging, usually we will write the constant first, then we write the variables. So here 2 is there, 2 5s are 10. Next x is there, x power 5 minus 1, x power 5 minus 1 is only but x power 4. So x power 4, next we will write the sine function, sine x power 5 into, next cos x power 5 into cos x cube minus 3 x square into sine x cube into sine square x power 5. That's all students, this is the answer for this particular question. Any doubts students?
No ma'am.